Hey everyone. This is a change from my usual strutting and posing vid. Something a bit more personal and from the heart. So if you're looking for me to be sexy, don't watch this vid. Recently, I got a job as an assistant for a very open-minded fashion designer in New York City. While riding the train to work, I have all these thoughts about self. I mean, who are we really? Are we the person that we've been conditioned to be because we were born with a certain set of genitalia between our legs? Or something more? And why, if we feel we can't be or act in accordance with what is considered to be normal, does anyone have a problem with us? Our society prides itself on being free or open-minded until an individual questions or tests this reality by acting or appearing different than what is expected. Even those that I've come out to have asked, why would I choose to do what I do, knowing it would probably get me some negative attention? My answer truly is that I don't choose to do what I do. Why would I choose to be ridiculed, or stared at, or called names? I am compelled to do what I do, because all my life I've tried to fit in so everyone else would feel good, but I was unhappy. Feeling these things from early childhood and keeping it all inside to fit in was torture. So here I am, at what is considered to be middle age, taking a new path, following my heart, my inner voice, and creating a new world where I am treated and accepted for who I feel I am, and not for who someone else thinks I have to be. Some have asked if I'm going to get a sex change now that I wear dresses, heels, or a flowery top, because again, they think this is what I should do so they can make sense of my new persona. I don't think so. I like all my parts and the way they work and feel. I prefer to stay androgynous or somewhere in the middle. I wouldn't mind growing a small pair of boobs in addition to what I already have. I really just want to have more options in my life of what I can wear and how I can present myself to the world. I know this pushes the buttons of others, but I'm not responsible for their thoughts and feelings about me. If they too were in touch with their own individuality, I wouldn't even be a concern. My ride on the train is like going through a dimensional vortex where I leave one world and enter another as someone else. Someone who was treated and accepted differently than the identity I left behind. So I get strange looks and some negative comments, but I also get people engaging me in pleasant conversations, asking me real questions about myself. As I walk from the train to work, I see so many people that are all so different from each other, and I'm just another one of them. It's a big, beautiful city with enough room for little old me. I hope to make some friends with common thoughts and interests who I can hang out with or have a stayover when I'm out late in the city. The fear of people pointing at me and ridiculing me was paralyzing and filled me with shame, only because I knew what I was doing wasn't considered by others to be normal. But after giving it some serious thought and looking around the internet, I realized there is no normal. I found a whole community of people looking like me from all around the world. So I took a major step to free myself from hiding who I am and answered an ad for employment in the Big Apple, New York City, a place where it said you can reinvent yourself. And now I work part-time as Rachel. We all come into this world alone, and we all leave the same way. So the lesson in that is we really have to live our lives as individuals, free from all the boxes and labels, to truly experience this thing called life. Otherwise, it's just an existence full of unreasonable expectations placed on us by others. The fact that we exist at all is a wonderful thing, and we should enjoy every day and allow others to do the same without judging or comparing. When we think everyone should be the same way, we end up arguing and blaming others for our own small-mindedness. I really enjoy my job, taking all the things I've learned in my life and applying them to my new job and self. Working around beautiful clothes and talented people like me. My day goes by so fast because I feel so good when people come into the boutique and I'm treated like I'm perfectly normal and I belong. My intention isn't to annoy or shock anyone. I just want to live and be like everyone else. At the end of the day, that's all any of us want. To live, create, earn a living, and be appreciated and loved. We are a rainbow of many individual sizes, shapes, thoughts, gender IDs, beliefs, traditions, and colors. I found myself, and with the help and kindness of others, created a world for me to be in. I hope everyone finds a place or creates one that suits them. And that all others learn tolerance and acceptance of each other. Bottom line, it's all about the love.